reach immunity levels sufficient to limit the spread of COVID-19. That's according to Dr. Anthony Fauci, who says the country has almost reached the end of the full-blown pandemic. Fauci says when that happens, local health agencies should feel comfortable ending the mask mandates. Optimism has been fueled by the rapid decline of daily U.S. infections. However, the U.S. remains on track to reach 1 million COVID deaths in April.
Joining us now is Dr. Robert Murphy, a professor of infectious diseases at Northwestern University Feinberg School of Medicine. Good morning, doctor.
Hey, good morning.
A new drug for Omicron. Is this something that only affects Omicron, and why would we need it if it doesn't seem to be overly serious?
Well, these monoclonal antibodies really help early on in the infection. The problem is that most of the ones that were out there stopped working for Omicron. Mm. This one by Eli Lilly actually works great for Omicron, as does the GSK one.
And there was a study done in monkeys about the Omicron booster. I didn't know there was a specific booster for Omicron. Talk about that.
Well, you know, the companies have been saying they're going to make an Omicron booster.
Okay.
So you start with monkeys first. So this is the Moderna booster specifically for Omicron. And it didn't do any better than the original vaccine.
Meaning we probably won't need something different. What we're getting already is fine.
Well, the only trouble is it's like a couple monkeys, and that doesn't really necessarily translate to humans, but it's actually kind of a good sign that says maybe the current vaccines are good enough for now.
Gotcha.
And where are we on protection from a prior infection? You have always said that boosters and so forth add better protection than if you were simply just infected. Yep.
Well, there's a big study from Qatar, the country, and they looked at a huge chunk of their population that had a variety of different coronavirus infections. And with Omicron, the Omicron infection alone without a vaccine protected those people for over 300 days. So this may be what your first story about Dr. Fauci saying, you know, maybe we're going to wind down a little bit now because so many people got Omicron. And if that gives that kind of protection, it all fits together, and you know, maybe there won't be another big wave. But we've said this before, and we'll see.
All right, let's get to some viewer questions. This person says, our K-6 school board has decided to make masks optional. Would you continue to wear a mask if you worked in a school?
Yes, absolutely, because there's too many unvaccinated people.
Here's the next question. When the COVID vaccine becomes available for my 2-year-old, should I even bother getting it for her? There won't be many cases by then.
Well, we don't know if there'll be how many cases there'll be by then. You know, kids take a variety of vaccines to prevent diseases that you don't see anymore because you're taking the vaccine. So, if the recommendation comes out and the American Association of Pediatrics and the NIH and CDC all agree, then you should take it.
All right. How about this question? When the mask mandate is lifted, what precautions should the unvaccinated take? Do they need to wear a mask?
Well, they should, because they don't have the protection that the vaccine is giving them. Now, if the cases get down to almost nothing, that's a different story.
All right. Well, if you didn't get your question answered by Dr. Murphy, he answers them biweekly on Northwestern University's Institute for Global Health Facebook page. You can also submit questions via email or head to our Morning News Facebook.